All right, this is the module 6 practice exam. So let's get this thing going, see how it works out. All right, we've only got 12 questions here, but that'll prepare us for the exam pretty well. Find the vertex, focus, directrix, and focal width of the parabola. The focal width, we hadn't really talked about. That's really the, like if we have a parabola and the focus is right here, that's the width at the focus point. That's what we call the focal width. But let's see if we can determine it through the rest of this. The focal width is actually 4P. Whatever the P is, 4 times that would be what the focal width would be. So let's look at a problem. Find the vertex, focus, directrix, focal width of this parabola. So we know there's two forms of the equation. The parabola is always the x squared equation, right? That's a quadratic equation makes a parabola. And our general equation is x squared equals 4py, but this is the alternate way. You can rearrange that and solve that for y, and it's y equals 1 over 4p x squared. All right, so just moving the 4py over here, dividing by that, it's 1/4. It could be x squared over 4p. That's the same thing as multiplying it by 1 over 4p, but just moving the 4p to the other side. So this tells us if 1 over 4p equals 1 over 40, negative, the 1's the same, so that means 4p has to equal negative 40. Because that's what we have. We have a negative 40 there. Instead of just 1 over 4p, we got 1 over negative 40, which makes it a negative. So if we divide this by 4, our p is equal to negative 10. Okay, p equals negative 10. So we know the vertex is the hk. There is no h, there is no k. Right, because otherwise we would have the x minus h in parentheses and the y minus k. But since we don't have either of those in parentheses, it's just x and y, that means our h and k must be 0. So the vertex is 0, 0. And when we look at our choices, all of them are 0, 0. So that doesn't help us narrow anything down. To find the focus points, we take the k. It would be the point H, which is 0, and K, and we would add the P to it. Well, our P is negative 10. So that means our focus point is 0, negative 10, because we don't have any other numbers for HK. They're 0. So which one is 0, negative 10? Okay, there's two of them. So this one's out, and this one's out. We've eliminated those, but those have the wrong focus point. If you remember our directrix is y equals, and it's the k minus the p. Okay. So in this case, it's y equals 0 minus negative 10. Since our p is a negative 10, what's 0 minus negative 10? Well, that's positive 10. Y equals 10 is our directrix. So that is y equals 10. Okay, that didn't help us either. Either both the same. So then we got to go up to this focal width being 4p. P is negative 10. Oh, it's actually the absolute value. I forgot that absolute value. But since it's the distance, it can't be negative 40. Because this is the distance from here to here would be 40, 4 times P. But it's the absolute value. So if it's a negative, you make it a positive because we're talking about a distance. So this focal width is 40. This has to be our correct answer. That's the only difference. All right, find the standard form of the equation of the parabola with a focus at 0, negative 2, and a directrix at y equals 2. Okay, so that'll tell us a few things. The directrix at y equals 2, we know it's the center, the k of the center of the parabola, the vertex, and we add p to it. So let's look at ours. All of these, the focus is a 0, negative 2. The direction is y equals 2. Let's think about where those points are. Y equals 2 is a horizontal line right there. And that's the directrix. The focus is at 0, negative 2 down here. So this must be an upside down parabola that is on the y-axis. Right, because 0 is the h. And since the vertex is halfway between the directrix and the focus, and this is 2 above the origin and this is 2 below the origin, the origin must be our vertex. Just by visualizing where these things are, we can see that. This is 2 above, this is 2 below, which tells us that our P equals 2, because P is the distance from the vertex to the directrix and the vertex to the focus. Since we know that, that'll help us come up with the equation. We see it is a up and down, right? So it's if it's up or down, then that means we are dealing with an x squared. So these y squared ones are eliminated right away because y squared are sideways, right? That's y squareds over here. And it could be the other way. It depends if p is greater than or equal to 0. We'll tell you if it's right or if it's left. All right. So on this one, ours is pointing down because the focus is down here. So our p must actually be a negative 2. Our p is a negative 2 because the directrix is k minus p. Our directrix is at y equals positive 2. So 0 minus 2 would not be a positive 2. It has to be a negative 2. So our p is negative 2. So let's look at our equation. It's obviously using this one from last one, y equals 1 over 4px squared. We know the p is negative 2 just because it's a downward facing. P has to be less than 0 for it to be downward facing. So that would make this a y equals 1 over 4 times negative 2 x squared equals 1 over 8, and it's negative 2, so it's a negative 8 x squared. Well, that's right there. That's right there. Y equals negative 1 8 x squared. All right, find the standard form of the equation of the parabola with a focus at negative 8, 0, and a directrix at x equals 8. Well, let's picture that. Negative 8, 0 is way over here, and that's where the focus is. That's the middle of the parabola. The directrix is at x equals 8. That's way over here. That's where this directrix line is. So this is a parabola that must open this way. And since the vertex is halfway in between those, the vertex must go through the origin. This is 8 this distance, and this is 8 this distance, since that's halfway. So again, we're talking about a vertex of 0, 0, because it's right on the x-axis. So we know the y is 0, and halfway in between is x equals 0. So 0, 0 is our vertex. Our p is 8. It could be negative 8. Which way is this opening? This is opening to the left, so that means it is a negative 8. And again, our directrix is x equals 8. This is the opposite way. Instead of the y equals, this is an x equals. X equals 1 over 4p y squared. This is a y squared because it opens left and right. Y squared is open left and right. And if the p is greater than 0, then it opens this way. Remember, that should be in your notes. If p is less than 0, it opens this way. This one opens this way because the focus is always in the middle of the parabola. So we know this is a negative 8. So if x equals 1 over 4 times negative 8 y squared, x equals negative 1/32 y squared. 4 times negative 8. Oh, that's right there. X equals negative 1/32 y squared. So it helps to pay attention where the focus and directors are. You might draw a little graph, say, okay, that means it's pointing this way. It helps you figure out if your P is supposed to be negative or positive. It also helps you figure out by the X equals 8, because it would be X equals the K minus P. And since it's 0 for the K, X equals 0 minus P. What does it have to be if X equals 8? 8 equals 0 minus P, which just means 8 equals negative P. So if 8 equals negative P and you want to know what P is, you got to divide both sides by negative 1. So P equals negative 8. It's another way to do it mathematically. We know X equals K minus P. For the up and down ones, it's Y equals K minus P. But for the left ones, it's the X equals. So since you know it's 8 equals 0 minus P, which means 8 equals negative P. So, all right, let's move on. A building has an entry the shape of a parabolic arch, 84 feet wide, 42 feet wide at the base. Okay, this is one of those where we can see it goes through the origin, so the vertex is 0, 0. So we know it should just be an XY equation. Oh, and it is. This is one that opens down, right? So that is your standard X squared quadratic formula. So these Y squareds are eliminated already. So it's got to be one of these two X squareds. But which is it, negative 21Y or negative 5.3Y? So let's look at that. The equation for a parabola, X squared equals 4PY. Now we were using the other Y equals 1 over 4PX squared before. We're going to go back to the original equation now because that's the form these are in. This is in the X squared form. So this is the same we were using on the other. We're just going back to the other form. These are the same equations, just rearranged for the Y equals or the X squared equals. So 4PY, so we need to find out what P is, and that'll tell us whether it's negative 21 or negative 5.3. We see it's negative, it's below that. So since this is X squared equals 4PY, we need to find a point on here to figure out what P is. So if this is 42 feet, and we know it's a mirror reflection over this line of symmetry, we know this is 84, so we know what this point is and this point is. Because we know the Y of this point over here is negative 84. Because it's 84 below the X. So that's negative 84. But what is the X coordinate? Well, if it's 42 from way over here to way over here, half of that would be 21. This is the point 21, negative 84. Means this point over here would be negative 21, negative 84. All right, we could use either one of those points, but let's use the one that has at least one positive number. So I know it's X squared. The X is 21 equals 4 times P times the Y, which is negative 84. Since we know a point that is on that parabola, this we can substitute the X and Y in, and this will tell us what the P is. All right, so we need to know what 21 squared is. So let's pull up our calculator. And take 21 and square it. 21 times 21 is 441. So 441 equals, and we can go ahead and multiply those together. 4 times negative 84. So 84 negative, there's negative 84, times 4. So this equals negative 336 P. So to find out what P is, we divide both sides by negative 336. Negative 336. And that will tell us what P equals. P equals 441 divided by a negative 336. So it's negative 1.3125. If the equation's x squared equals 4py, x squared equals 4 times negative 1.3125y. We can take this times 4. And it's 5 1/4. So it should be x squared equals negative 5.25y.
Not soon enough though, right?
Well, let's look at our choices.
Are you going back?
We got negative 21 and negative 5.3. They have taken this answer and rounded it up to the nearest tenth. So that has to be our answer. We just had to figure out what p was, use this equation, and multiply 4 times the p. All right, so now we're dealing with an ellipse. We moved out of the parabolas, and we're going to deal with an ellipse. So here's the equation. X squared over 81 plus y squared over 225 equals 1. And then wants to find the center, the vertices, and the foci. So the center, 0, 0. There's no x minus h. There's no y minus k. The h and k are 0. So we know the center, and it's the same in all four of them. That does not help us. But we need to know the vertices and the foci. So we know that a squared is always bigger than b squared with an ellipse. So this is a squared because the equation is x squared over a or b squared, y squared over a, b squared, and whichever one is bigger is the a. So this is b squared, this is a squared. So if a squared, I'm just going to write the 225 first. If a squared equals 225, then a will equal 15.
So
we'll just take the positive value that a is 15, because 15 times 15 is 225. And if b squared equals 81, b equals 9. Okay? So the vertex for an ellipse, and this ellipse is which way? Is that vertical or is that horizontal? If the larger number, if the a squared, the larger number is underneath the y, then that means it's a tall, it's a vertical. If the y has the bigger number. If the x has the bigger number, then it would be a left-right ellipse, but ours is not left right. Ours is a vertical. So with a vertical, then we're going to add, this is a is the distance to the vertices. Distance to vertices. So from the center, from 0, 0, which is the center of our ellipse, we can add 15 to this and get to the vertices. And this is talking about the major vertices. So ours is up and down. So that means we're going to add it to the y because we want to go up and down. So our vertices are going to be at 0, 15 and 0, negative 15 because it goes up and down. So this is negative 15, 0. That's moving it left and right. We can eliminate that one. That goes up and down. This is left and right. This is up and down. Okay, so we have narrowed it down because the distance to the vertices is A. The distance to the foci is C. C is the distance to the foci. So we've got to use our equation for an ellipse. Let me get some extra paper here. An ellipse, it's a squared equals b squared plus c squared. All right, that's defined what c is. So our a squared was 225. Our b squared is 81 plus c squared. So let's subtract that over there. Subtract 81. Get c squared by itself. So that's 144 equals c squared. So if c squared is 144, then c equals 12.
What about you,
Isabella? Because 12 times 12 is 144. So taking the square root of both sides gives us 12. So the distance from the center, which remember our center for this one is 0, 0, is 12. And it has to be up and down because this is a vertical ellipse. So that means our foci is going to be at negative 12 and positive 12, not 9, 0. Right? So it's going to be that one right there. Because we eliminated the others. They have the wrong vertices, the wrong focus points. All right, here's another one. A little different. They give us an equation that looks like this. Well, for the ellipse, as we know it, we need it to be equal to 1. So let's just divide everything by 16. So x squared, 2x squared divided by 16 is x squared divided by 8. Because 2 over 16 is 1/8. Plus 8y squared divided by 16 is now y squared over 2, because 8/16 is 1/2. And it will equal 1, because 16 divided by 16 is 1. Okay, so this is an equation that looks more like the ellipse equations we're used to. But now, obviously, the larger number is under the x, so this is one of these, goes that way. There is no x minus h, y minus k. So those are 0. So again, all of our choices are the same. What is our a? This is a squared. Remember, a is the distance between the center point and the vertices. It's not 8. So this has it going a distance of 8. It's not 8. It's a squared equals 8. So we take the square root of that. A equals the square root of 8, which is the same thing as the square root of 4 times 2. And the square root of 4 is 2. So it's 2 square roots of 2. Because we can take the square root of 4. So this is the same thing as the square root of 8, 2 square roots of 2. So it's one of these two. So we know that the x has the larger number. So it's this way, not this way. All right. It's not that way. So we need to add the 2 square roots of 2 to the x value, right? Because it's moving on the x. It's still 0 over here for the y. It hasn't gone up any. It's a y, but we need a number for the x. So this takes the square 2 square roots of 2 and adds it to the y. 0, 2 square roots of 2. Well, that would be up here somewhere. And the negative one would be below that. 2 square roots of 2 and negative 2 square roots of 2 is above and below because the x is 0. So that's wrong because that would be one that's shaped this way going up and down as the major axis. It should be the x on this side. So we don't even have to check the foci because this is the only one that has the correct vertices where the ellipse is horizontal. This is vertical. No, that is wrong. Has to be horizontal. So that saved us some trouble. We didn't have to figure out what C was because we see already that that's the only choice that's correct. All right, here, one problem right here on this page. Graph the ellipse with the equation x squared over 36 plus y squared over 49 equals 1. Okay, well, here's four different ones. The first thing we need to figure out is what is the center of our ellipse? What is the h and the k? Well, it's just x, so it must be x minus 0 and y minus 0. So our center is 0, 0. Well, right away, this one can be eliminated. That's not 0, 0. This one is. That one's not 0, 0. This one is. So it's got to be one of these two. So let's see. Which number is larger? Well, obviously the 49 is larger, so that is the a squared. If that's the y has the larger number, that means our ellipse goes like this. Because the y is larger, has the larger number. So it's the y's. So which one of these would that be? It's hard to see it, but this is at negative 6. This is at negative 7. It's not much difference, but this one is taller than it is wide. That is the one that is the vertical. This one is wider than it is tall. we can see that a little easier. See, it's wider and tall. So that's the wrong one. It's got to be the last one. All right. A lot we can tell just from the equation there. All right. Find an equation in standard form for the ellipse with a vertical major axis. That means the ellipse is going to be taller than it is wide. Of length 10, that's the total from this top to the bottom, 10. And a minor axis of length 8. So it's 8 from left to right. So that means if we had a graph of that, we can put it at, there is no H or K, so we can put it at 0, 0 right here. And we know the total length from up here to down here is 10. So from the center, this must be 5. So this must be the point 0, 5 and 0, negative 5. That would give us a total length of 10. This length is 8. So this must be the point 4, 0 and negative 4, 0. Because that would be total length on the axis of 8. So let's see, if this is a vertical axis, then that means from the center to the vertex is 5. That must be what A equals. A equals 5 because that is the distance. Okay, so if that is the distance to that, then let's see, that means vertical, that has to be y squared a squared. It has to go underneath the y squared to be a vertical. This would be x squared over here, and it has to have the b squared. We don't know what b is at this point, but we know y a squared would be y squared over 25. So which of these has that? Y squared over 4? Nope. Y squared over 5? Nope. Y squared over 25? Y squared over 16. There's only one of them that even has y squared over 25, so that has to be the correct answer. We don't even have to find out what the b is. We don't care, because this told us right here there's only one of those equations that it can possibly be, just by finding the a, which is the distance from the vertex to the center. All right, find the vertices and the foci of the hyperbola with this equation. We're out of the ellipse now. That was an ellipse. This is a hyperbola. X plus 5 squared over 36, because this is a minus. It's a plus with an ellipse. This is a minus. So let's look at that and see. So we know that with a hyperbola, it's the x plus h squared over a squared minus y minus k squared over b squared equals 1. Now, for the hyperbola, the a does not have to be the largest number. The a is always the first number. So this is a squared. So we know our a equals 6, and we know our b equals, what's the square root of 64? 8. So we know our a and b right away. So the question is this a vertical or horizontal? So looking at our equation, we have the x squared first over the a squared. That means this is a horizontal, means our hyperbola looks something like that, the arrows, horizontal because the x squared first. For the vertical, the up and down, you would have the y squared over the a squared. That's not the case here. This is the x squared over the a squared. So since the x squared is first, we know that this is a horizontal hyperbola. And so for horizontal hyperbolas, if we want to find the foci, we take the h and we add plus or minus c. Okay, that would be the points for the foci. We'd add c to the h and subtract c from the h, and that'd give us our two focus points. And for the vertex, the two vertices, we have two vertex because there's one over here and one over here from the center. We take the center, h plus k, and we add and subtract the a from the H. Now, if this was not horizontal, so this one's horizontal, we said. Kind of wrote that quickly. If this was vertical, these would both be off the K. We'd be adding and subtracting to the K instead of the H. But since these are horizontal, we're adding and subtracting. So right away we knew our two vertices. H, what is our H? Let's find our H and K. We haven't done that. So X, well, it's X minus. I don't know what I put a plus there. X minus H over Y minus K. If X plus 5 is the same as X minus H, that means 5 equals minus H. So H must equal negative 5. So we have negative 5 plus A. What's A? 6. And our K, Y plus 1. So K must equal negative 1 because minus K equals positive 1. So negative 1 is our K. So what's negative 5 plus 6? 1, negative 1. 1, negative 1 is one of our vertices. The other vertices, the other vertex, negative 5 minus 6. We got one of them that we add and one of them that we subtract. Negative 5 minus 6 is negative 11 minus 1. So we're looking for these two vertices. Nope. Oh, 1, negative 1. There's that one. Negative 11, negative 1. Okay, that one's good. Oh, this one's negative 1, 1. And negative 1, negative. Okay, that one's backwards. It has some things. It's doing the K. It's adding it to the K on this one instead of the H. Add subtraction. So we don't even have to worry about finding the foci because there's only one of these that even qualified to have the right vertex. So that's nice that eliminated that. Otherwise, we'd have to go find out what C is. And with a hyperbola, C squared equals, this is the Pythagorean theorem one. With this one, it's A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So we could go find C if we need to. But in this case, we don't need to because there's only one of them that has the proper vertices. All right. Let's see what else. Oh, another graphing problem. Graph the hyperbola with the equation x minus 1 squared over 49 minus y plus 3 squared over 9. So first, let's find the center. X minus h, x minus 1, y minus k, y minus negative 3. Y minus a negative 3 would give us y plus 3. So this is the center. So first, let's look and see. This is a center over at negative 1, 3. That's wrong. That's the wrong center. That's negative 1, 3. This looks like it has a center that's on the y-axis. So that's got to be wrong. Looks like it's the origin. This has a center on the origin. That can't be right. And this one looks like it's at, if I draw a line through there, it is at negative 3. And this is over at 8, and this is over at negative 6. The average between negative 8 and negative 6, the middle of that would be negative 1. So this one's at negative 1, 3, negative 3, I'm sorry, positive 1. Negative 6 and 8 would be positive 1, negative 3, which is what we needed. So this has to be the answer. We don't even have to get into the A's and the B's and the C's, A squared, B squared. We don't need any of that because there's only one of them that has the right center to start with. And since the x squared's first, we knew we were looking for one that did this. Right? Because if it was the y squared first, it would be an up and down. So this is up and down. This is up and down. Those are both wrong for that reason also. These are the only two that are left and right. And this is the one that has the proper center. All right. This is our last two questions. Find an equation in standard form for the hyperbola with vertices at 0, plus or minus 2, and foci at 0, plus or minus 11. So remember, for the vertices, we're adding A. And since this is plus or minus two, one's positive two, one's negative two, the center is zero. So that tells us that the center point is zero, zero. And the A is two away from the zero, because that's the center between positive two and negative two. Zero is the center. So it's a distance of two away. And then the other thing, the foci is where we add the C. So the C must be 11, because 11 would be the distance from 0, 0 to 0, 11, and 0, negative 11. So since that tells us the A and the C, we can find out what B is. Remember, with the hyperbolas, A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So A squared, 2 squared is 4, plus B squared equals C squared. 111 squared is 121. If you need your calculator to check that, do that. Subtract 4. So B squared equals 117. We know A squared equals 4. So which one of these has the proper A squared, B squared? The vertices are at, let's see, there's the origin. The vertices are at 0, 2, which is up here, and 0, negative 2. So this is an up, down. Just looking at where the vertices are. So that means if it's an up, down, the y squared must be over the a squared. If it was a left, right, the x squared would be over the a squared. Well, we need one where the y squared is over the 4. Okay, the y squared's over the 4. Oh, that's not right. Y squared's over, that's not right. This one has y squared over the 4. So these are both vertical hyperbolas. These are not. Well, these are. They're just different measurements. These are all have y squared first. But we know the a is 4. So this is the only one have the proper a. B squared is 117. So it has to be this first one. B squared. A squared is 4. B squared is 117. Process of elimination. Find an equation in the standard form of the hyperbola with vertices, okay, 0 plus or minus 8. So that again tells us that our center must be at 0, 0, and our A must be 8. And our asymptotes, Y equals plus or minus 1/2 x. So let's see, if we talk about the asymptote equation, looking in your notes, you would have that as k plus or minus a over b x minus h. So looking in your notes, that's what you'd have. Now, do we have a k? There's nothing in front of the plus minus, so our k must be zero. What's our h? X minus h, we just have an x, so that must be zero. So our center of our hyperbola is at 0, 0. So that simplifies things for us, which all of these have 0, 0. So there's no minus h or minus k. So that didn't help with these choices. But let's take it a step further. So if our equation is y equals plus or minus 1/2 x, and the original equation, if we make those zero, that would be y equals plus or minus a over b x. So that means 1/2 equals a over b. Right? A over b is going to be equal to 1/2. And a, we know, we've already figured out what that is because we know where the vertex is. So 1/2 equals 8 over something. How do we make this equal 1/2? Well, you can cross multiply if you need to, where b equals 16, 2 times 8. Or you can just know that 8 over 16 would be equal to 1/2, right? Whichever way works for you, but 1/2, the only way to make 8 over something where equal 1/2 is to make it a 16. So our B is 16. So knowing that, what is A squared? Because these use A squared and B squared, right? So A squared is 8 squared, which is 64. B squared is 16 squared. What is 16 squared? Well, if you like, we can put that back in our calculator. You don't know that right off the top of your head. It's 256. All right. So the question is, which one of these meets our qualifications for that? If the vertices are at the centers here in 0, 8, where's 0, 8? It's up here. So that means this is a vertical. 0, -8 be down here. This is a vertical, which means the y is first. Okay, all of these have y first. A squared is always over here. Remember, it's y squared over a squared minus x squared over b squared equals 1. So which of these has the proper? A squared is 64. That eliminates that first one. B squared is 256. B squared, nope. Hey, there it is. It's going to be this one. That has the wrong B squared. That has the wrong B squared. Process of elimination. This is the only one that has the correct B squared. And that's it. That is the Module 6 practice test. So if you had trouble on your practice test problems, you can look and see how I solved that and go back and figure out what you did wrong. So when you take the test, you won't struggle with that because you'll always say, oh, that's right. And if you have practice test notes, use those on the test. Say, okay, I took that. That problem's kind of like number 8. So I'm going to use my number 8 notes to figure out how to do this one on the test. All right, guys, you got it.